We still, subhanAllah, have in these days and all days and in the whole history, when sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to the people as a rahmat al-alameen, and we heard many insulting of him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, many abusing for him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, physically and in their talk, and all these accusations also, which happened, inshallah, I have khutbah next week. I will talk about our dear beloved Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and how could we defend his reputation sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What we have to do, actually. Inshallah, it will be in the khutbah. Let us today continue our program, and something about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Also, subhanAllah, there is accusation that he used a not proper words in one hadith from his hadith sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this hadith actually narrated or collected by Imam al-Bukhari, narrated by Imam ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, and it's hadith ahad. Ahad hadith means there is one chain only, but we have also to believe in it because it's mentioned in Imam al-Bukhari, Muslim Imam al-Bukhari, wa Ahmad aydan. But we have to know that hadith is ahad. Why? Because I'm going to explain it to you now. There is Ma'iz radiallahu anhu, one from as-sahaba Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, did adultery, zina. Then he came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he said, O Muhammad, purify me, tahirni, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In the beginning, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam didn't like to look at him, and he was just turning his face from Ma'iz radiallahu anhu wa arda. Why? Because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the most modest person, he had such of modesty, we cannot imagine that. And this accusation against this, I have to explain the hadith from the beginning, because same thing, we cut one word, and see, your prophet said this, how? He was modest person, why he said this word? It's like not proper word. Actually, I can't say it here in the masjid, or I can't say it, because it's not proper word. But why he said it, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I will tell you now. But let us take the hadith from the beginning. The beginning of the hadith that Ma'iz came to Rasulullah and said that I did zina, tahirni, purify me. Then Rasulullah ﷺ turned his face on him. Then he came to him and Rasulullah turned his face again. Then in the end, خلاص, because he wanted purification from Rasulullah ﷺ, Rasulullah asked him, ﷺ, did you only just her or you did zina? He said, no, I did zina. But did you just only touch her or you did zina? He said, no, I did zina. Purify me. He's talking about judgment now. Now this is the time of investigation. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam should that time had to ask him in details, had to say the word, did you make this thing? Then he said the word. Did you did this? He said the word. Then he said, yes, I did. He said, are you sure? He said, yeah. Before طبعاً إقامت الحدود, Rasulullah couldn't just take words from him that Rasulullah, I did zina. He wanted sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to make sure that he 100% did zina. Then he asked him, did you kiss only? No. Did you touch only? No. Did you? Did you make this thing, this action? He said, yes. Okay. Yeah, in the beginning, he wouldn't also like to just listen to him. After that, he just wanted to help him. Did you do this only? No, I did this. Did you do this only? No. Of course, this is the time of investigation. He had sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to ask him this proper word. And I will give you something. 1993 or 94 in Germany, this is mashallah, they have يعني, such of justice organizations. They decided that the judges should be asked clearly the accused people about their problem, what they did, about their cases. They have to ask them cure questions, direct questions. And also they have to tell them, like, with accurate way, did you kill him? Kill means kill. Because before طبعاً إقامة الحدود, because يعني, this is big thing. To did zina, this is big thing. But Rasulullah wanted only to make sure about his case. That's it. Then he said this word. Sallallahu alayhi wa Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yalla, bring your accusations and let us explain it one by one. Yes, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said this word. This word, it's not proper, but he didn't say it in front of people. He didn't say it in the masjid. He didn't say it in front of congregation people or something. No. He said it in front of him, and he asked that they like to listen to him in the beginning. Then after that, because of investigation place, he should, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ask him clear that, did you do this? And he said yes. Subhanallah, this hadith, ahad, why I said in the beginning of my talk, it's ahad. Because ahad means it's one chain. Just two sahaba only narrated this hadith. One, an ibn Abbas, an nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If Rasulullah said it in the masjid, that means this hadith became mutawatir. There is many chains and many people narrated it. And maybe there is people of you don't aslan know this word. Yani, you didn't listen to this hadith before, I think. But it mentioned in Bukhari, and there is people accused us and accused Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But this hadith is rare hadith, a had one, but mentioned in al-Bukhari and al-Muslim Imam al-Ahmad, we have to believe in it. Yes, Rasulullah said this word. Why? Because he had a special case, a special state, and he had sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to make sure that this person did this big sin, because he punished them already after he said that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gather us with al-Nabiyyin wa-Siddiqeen wa-Shuhada wa-Salihin. إنه على كل شيء قدير وأسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يغفر لنا ذنوبنا إنه على كل شيء قدير والسلام عليكم.